Good morning. So far we have seen a cantilever beam subjected to point load alone and cantilever beam subjected to UDL alone. Now we are going to see a cantilever beam subjected to a point load as well as uniformly distributed load. Okay, so cantilever beam AB of length 5 meter, which is subjected to UDL of 10 kilonewton per meter over the entire length or over the entire span of the cantilever beam. Also, it carries a point load of magnitude 50 kilonewton, which is acting downward at the free end of the cantilever beam. For this, we are going to calculate shear force and bending moment values. Then we are going to plot the shear force and bending moment diagram. So always for a cantilever beam, as I told you, we have to start our procedure, calculation procedure from the free end. Now let us get into the calculation of shear force values. Okay. So now, for example, I've got a UDL. So without taking any section also, we can calculate the shear force values. And we can plot it, but just to check the values mathematically, I'm just trying to write down the shear force expression. So I've taken a section, XX section, at a distance X from the free end B. So if you try to write down the shear force expression about this section XX, so we have to remember the sign convention, right side of the section, downward is positive. 50 kilonewton is acting downward positive, and UDL is acting downward, so 10 into run length is X. So 50 plus 10X is the expression for this UDL and point load, which is valid between A and B. Okay, that we need to remember, because we don't have any discontinuity or any addition of load, point loads between A and B. It is completely uniformly distributed load from A to B or from B to A. So this expression is valid from B to A. That is between the limits 0 and 5 meter at B, X is 0. So the shear force at B or BB, whatever it is, just substitute 0 here. Shear force is 50 kilonewton. Okay. So from right hand side, downward is positive. So 50 kilonewton. So from B to A, it is UDL. So nature of the shear force diagram is a triangle. There's a triangle, inclined straight lines, okay, inclined lines. Then at X is equal to, at A, X is equal to 5 meter, shear force at A is nothing but substitute 5 meter in this expression, you get 100 kilonewton. Okay, it's a UDL. So this is the nature of the shear force diagram for UDL. So already I told you, at the fixed end of a cantilever beam, shear force is always maximum. Okay, so this is the positive shear force. When you come to the bending moment diagram, okay, so right side of the section, right side clockwise negative, anti-clockwise positive. This is a sign convention we have to remember. So BM XX, so 50 into X, force into a particular distance, 50 into X minus, then 10 into X, which becomes Newton per meter into meter Newton. The 10 into X will act at a distance of X by 2, X by 2. So about this section, 10 into X clockwise, so minus 10 into X into moment arm is X by 2, X by 2. Force into perpendicular distance. So at B, X is equal to 0. Bending moment at B is 0. I told you already at the beginning of this chapter, bending moment is always zero at the tip of a cantilever beam when it is subjected to UDL or point load or a combination of UDL and point load. Okay, shear force is zero only when it is subjected to UDL alone. Please try to understand. Now at A, X is equal to 5 meter. At the A, X is equal to 5 meter bending moment at A, substitute here, x is equal to 5 meter, you get minus 375 kilonewton meter. So here at B, bending moment is 0. At A, bending moment is minus 375 kilonewton meter. The nature of the bending moment diagram for UDL is parabolic, okay, which must be plotted below this baseline as it is negative value. Okay, and complete the figure. And bending moment is also maximum at the fixed end of a cantilever beam. Next problem. So if you look at this, you have a combination of UDL and a point load, but UDL is spread partially over a length of 2 meter from the fixed end, and a point load is acting at the free end or at the tip of a cantilever beam. Okay, so without writing expression also you can plot the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram, very simple. Now let us proceed from the free end B. So when we proceed from the right end, okay, so 20 kilonewton is acting downward, so right end downward positive, so 20 kilonewton should be shown by a vertical line. B to C, no load, shear force remains constant. Shear force remains constant. From C to A, okay, it's a UDL, so it's inclined lines or triangular lines, whatever it is, okay. Now, let me take one section, then I will just give the value directly also. Now, I have taken a section. I'm going to write down the shear force expression about the section XX, which means that I have to consider all the forces acting to the right side of the section XX. I have to consider all the forces, okay. So, SF at XX is equal to 20 downward positive. This phi UDL is acting downward, so 5 into X. Now you see, I can cross-check this answer. You see, at C, I am having 20 kilonewton. I can cross-check mathematically with this expression. So at C, X is equal to 0. So shear force at C is equal to 20 kilonewton, which checks mathematically. Now this expression is valid between C and A. That is, between the limit 0 and 2 meter. At A, X is equal to 2 meter. So shear force at A, substitute here 2, you get 30 kilonewton. So nature is inclined line, inclined straight line, okay. And complete the shear force diagram. Now how will you find or how will you write the values for the shear force without writing this expression? For example, okay, up to this C, you have got 20 kilonewton, okay, 20 kilonewton. And you see 5 into 10, 5 is the UDL. Multiply the complete run length 10. So 10 plus 20. So already up to C, you have 20 kilonewton acting downward. This UDL multiply by total run length 5 into 2, 10. So 10 plus 20, so both are acting downward. Sum it up, you get 30. So complete the shape of the diagram. So like this, you can calculate without writing any expression. But if you write the expression, it will be easy to cross-check the answers, okay. Then the bending moment diagram. So I told you already, bending moment at B is zero at the free end, okay. And you see bending moment at C will be force into perpendicular distance, 20 into 3, 60 kilonewton meter, right side clockwise negative. So it is plotted below the baseline. Okay, so now when you just write down the expression about XX, 20 into X plus 3, right side clockwise negative, and minus 5 into X by 2. Okay, 5 into X is the force, into perpendicular distance is X by 2. Now you can cross check this 60 kilonewton meter by applying the limit X to be 0. So at C, X is 0. So bending moment at C is minus 60 kilonewton meter, which checks this answer. Then at A, X is equal to 2 meter. So bending moment at A is minus 110 kilonewton meter. So nature of the bending moment diagram is a parabola. Complete the figure. very, very, very simple. Okay, at A, if you want to find out, you can find out 20 into 5 plus 5 into 2 into 1. So you will get the same answer, minus 110. You can check it. Next, cantilever beam subjected to a uniformly varying load, that is a triangular load. Okay. So this is a cantilever beam AB of length L. Okay, so the load is W per unit length at the fixed end, which is maximum, and it is gradually decreasing and making to be zero at the free end. Okay, so we can call it as a gradually varying load or triangular load or uniformly varying load. Now, how to find the shear force values and bending moment values and how to plot the same for this given loading? Okay, so since I need some space here, I've just moved this line shear force diagram baseline to the left hand side, but it should be aligned with A and B length, overall length. Okay, please keep in mind while plotting in your paper. So now let me take a section XX at a distance X from the free end. Now write down the shear force expression. Okay, so before writing it, let this distance or let this height be y, okay, small letter y, okay, let this height be y. You can see here this triangle and this triangle are similar. So from similar triangles I can write y by x is equal to w by l, which gives y is equal to wx by l, y is equal to wx by l, because I need this height to write down the shear force expression. So shear force expression, I'm writing about section XX, shear force expression. So I have to consider all the loads acting to the right side of the section XX. So area of the triangle, the area of this triangle gives you the shear force actually. So off into X into Y, off into X into Y, or off into y into x, your wish. Y is nothing but wx by l. So if you just substitute here, wx square by 2l. This is the shear force expression. And you can see here, the shear force expression contains x square term, which means that the nature of the shear force diagram is parabolic in nature. So at B, x is zero. So the shear force at B will be zero, okay? And this expression, shear force expression, valid between A and B. We don't have any other loads acting between A and B. It is only one load is acting, which is uniformly varying load. At A, X is equal to L, then shear force at A is nothing but substitute L here. You will get WL by 2, which is the shear force at A. So this is the parabola. Here, WL by 2 is the shear force. Okay, positive. Because when you proceed from right-hand side, downward is positive. When you go for the bending moment diagram, similarly write down the expression. Okay, write down the expression for the bending moment. So right side clockwise is negative, so I have taken minus here. The area of this triangle gives you the load off into x into y, where y is the wx by l. So off into wx by l into x. So off into y into x is nothing but the force or the load, where this load is acting exactly at CG of the small triangle. So this load into this distance. So off into wx by l into x is acting here at CG. For a triangle, CG distance will be 1 by 3 of x, and this is 2 by 3 of x. So here the load is acting, this load into this particular distance, 1 by 3 of x, gives you the bending moment. So minus is clockwise right side of the section. So you get wx cube by 6l with minus, because clockwise when you proceed from right hand side. If you look at the bending moment expression, it is having x cube, which means that the nature of the bending moment diagram for UVL is cubic curve in nature. So at B, x is 0, so bending moment at B is 0. At A, x is equal to L, substitute, you will get minus WL square by 6 is the bending moment at A. So this is the cubic and this is the parabolic. So complete the figure. So this is a parabolic curve. The exam will write out like this. When you get UVL particularly, just to differentiate. Parabolic curve, and here it is, cubic curve. So next, cantilever beam subjected to a clockwise couple at the free end. Couple means a moment is acting, okay? Moment is acting at the free end like this. Cantilever beam AB of length L, couple or a moment M is acting clockwise. You can put anti-clockwise as you wish. You see what happens. Okay, so now the beam is subjected to moment alone, that is Newton meter, moment alone, okay? Which means that when a beam is subjected to a bending moment alone, the shear force would be zero on that beam. Or the shear force would be zero along the length of the beam. This is very, very important. Suppose if you perform any software analysis in ANSYS or any other analysis software, subjected to moment alone means you would get shear force value, but it would be in the order of 10 power minus 6 or minus 7 Newton, something like that, which could be assumed as zero theoretically. So I told you the zero shear force, you will not get any shear force. In addition to moment, if any load, point load or UDL is acting, means you will get the shear force diagram. Please remember, now here moment alone is acting. Okay, so you will not get any shear force. You can simply draw a line and leave it, okay? Because zero shear force. When you come to the bending moment diagram, always you remember when a couple is acting on a beam, the couple must be shown by a vertical line. Depending upon its direction of action, whether it's a clockwise or anti-clockwise, whether you be proceed from left side or right side, it should be shown by the increment or decrement. That is, it should be shown by a vertical line acting upward or acting downward. Okay, so we must remember that in a beam, when a couple is given, it should be shown by a vertical line. Very, very important. Okay, so now at the tip B, I'm proceeding from right hand side. So M is acting clockwise. So bending moment will be M acting clockwise. So minus M. So this is the bending moment. And from B to A, no load is acting. Bending moment remains constant. And complete the figure. Okay, so this is the bending moment diagram when a cantilever beam is subjected to a clockwise couple M at the free end. Suppose at B, if anti-clockwise couple is acting, means this M or this rectangle which you have plotted below the baseline will come on the top of it. That is positive. You get top of this small rectangle, positive bending moment diagram. Okay, because from the right hand side, anti-clockwise is positive. Next, we'll go to a simply supported beam again, subjected to a triangular load. Okay, subjected to a triangular load. Okay, so earlier case we have seen only one half of this triangle acting on a cantilever beam. Now you could see a complete triangular load acting on a simply supported beam. That is, load is maximum or exactly at a distance of L by 2, that is at point C, and load is zero on either side of the support. That is, it starts from zero. Okay, doesn't mean that exactly zero, it starts from zero. The load starts from zero at A, reaches a maximum W at C. Similarly, load starts from zero from B, reaches a maximum W at L by 2, okay, from B. For this, we need to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. Okay, so when you look into this loading, the loading is perfectly symmetric. The loading is perfectly symmetric. So what I told you already, whenever on a simply supported beam, if the loads are symmetric, means sum up all the loads acting downward, okay, divided by 2, that would be the value of the support reaction. Now, total load acting on the beam is just off into L by 2 into W twice. So I multiply by 2, which is nothing but W L by 2 is the load acting on the beam downward. So if this load is divided by 2, you will get the support reaction RA RB. Okay, so RA is equal to RB is equal to WL by 4 is the support reaction. Okay, now let us consider a section XX at a distance X from the left hand support A to write the shear force expression, to determine the shear force values, to plot the shear force diagram. Then SFXX. So as I told you already, this height we have to calculate from the similar triangles, like y by x is equal to w by l by 2. Okay, we are considering this is l by 2, so y is equal to 2wx by l. So SFXX, okay, about this left hand side, upward is positive, downside is negative, RA is wl by 4. And this is acting downwards, minus area of this off into x into y. So y is nothing but 2wx by l, off into x into y, okay, off into x into y. Y is 2wx by l. So wl by 4 minus wx square by l. You can see here the shear force expression contains power 2. So the nature of the shear force diagram will be a parabola for UVL. Uniformly varying load. So at A, x is equal to 0. So you'll get shear force to be WL by 4 if you substitute here. Similar thing happens when you proceed from the right hand side also, because it's a symmetric load. Same load is acting on the right hand side, and same support reaction also. RA is equal to RB. So you'll get from the right hand side means upward is negative, that is minus WL by 4, you will get shear force at B. Now, when you come for the shear force diagram, you see here WL by 4, I am proceeding from left hand side, upward is positive. From right hand side means upward is negative, you can see minus WL by 4. Then what would be the shear force at C? Okay, we know that between A to B, UVL is acting, okay, there's any other load is acting, okay, like a uniformly distributed load or a point load or a couple, it is perfectly UVL is acting, which is symmetric. Okay, so at C, x is equal to L by 2, the shear force at C is 0. So from A to C, you will have one parabola, then C to B, another parabola. Okay, so positive here, here it is negative. When you write the bending moment expression, WL by 4 into X, WL by 4 into X, area of this diagram will be the load or a force acting on this section XX, off into X into Y. And this force is acting at a distance of 1 by 3 from the section XX or 2 by 3 from the support A, because CG is here for the triangle. So off into X into Y into 1 by 3 of X. So at A, X is equal to 0. So bending moment at A is 0. Okay. Then at C, X is equal to L by 2. At C, X is equal to L by 2. Substitute here X is equal to L by 2. You'll get bending moment to be 0.0833 WL square. So you'll get cube term in the bending moment expression, which means that the bending moment diagram nature is a cubic curve. Okay, and bending moment is zero at the simply supported ends. So this is a cubic curve, and here the shear bending moment is maximum, that is 0.08333 WL square, and here the shear force is zero. Okay, so this is a parabolic and this is the cubic curve. Thank you.